Hello everyone. Madvika was just making fun of how I say that way. Fuck you, Jeff. But yeah, hey people watching, how you doing? You're watching this in the middle of the ECUM 2 year anniversary. Are you having fun? I hope you are. If you're not, if you're watching this after the fact, I don't care if you're having fun. But yeah, we're gonna watch She-Hulk episode
Oh,
three.
damn.
Why would I care about my audience? You know, if they're not celebrating ECUM, we shouldn't celebrate having an audience. Anyway, we're both gonna watch She-Hulk episode three, not because we care about this show, not because we're gonna react to
I
this show
do.
like people have been telling us to react to the entire show, and not because we've watched previous episodes, though Jeb has. It is simply because Madvikin and I are known for not being the biggest fans of Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings, and that film does something that is quite weird to me, which is to have Wong fighting Abomination in that underground fighting ring run by Xialing. And so we wanted to know, hey, maybe She-Hulk would address this, considering what we knew about the promos of this show. And it turns out it did. It did address what the reasons why Wong did it in Shang-Chi. And so I'm very excited to see Madvika's reaction to it. I already know the reason, but Madvika doesn't. And
I don't.
you do. You read it
Jeb,
in the server, Joe.
I didn't. I just brushed aside. I didn't read properly.
Oh, okay, that's good then. But
Didn't read properly.
yeah, I don't know. Man, but could you also have another reason, which is, you know, a specific comment if you'd like to, I guess, line out why what that comment said to you and why you're so hell-bent on seeing what if the reason is good or
Yes, I am indeed hellbent because on that Shang-Chi video, I've received a comment which goes like this. They say, "I really like this video, but some of the things you point out seems to be nitpicking for the sake of it. Like the Wong stuff in the Macao portion of the video. You asked why Abomination and Wong are even associated and how Abomination even got out of his cell. I didn't question that. I know how he got out. Wong opened portals, which is out of character. So that's not a question of mine." And then they follow with, "Isn't that kind of the point?" See, they're defending the key jangling moments because they say, "Oh, of course it'll be answered later."
Of course.
They say there's missing information in that scene that's obviously supposed to set up another story. I would compare it to nitpicking about how Nick Fury knows Carol Danvers before even watching Captain Marvel.
What? Oh, that's not. Oh, okay. That's the comparison. That comparison is stupid.
Yeah, so Nick Fury, I'm assuming they're talking about the pager where he drops it
Yeah,
in
the point is
Infinity
that
War.
before watching Captain Marvel, you're like, wait, how does Nick Fury know Captain Marvel? That doesn't make any sense. And that's the same thing as you saying that Abomination and Wong and Shang-Chi doesn't make any sense because obviously it's just set up for later. It's gonna be explained how he knows Abomination. But that was never like your criticism, like how he knows him, right? Because he's a villain that tore
That was.
Harlem. I imagine the bigger reason is like why would he take him out of his cell and fight him?
Yes, because I don't see Wong. Well, Wong's kind of all over the place in terms of his morals and personality. I thought he was established in Doctor Strange 1 as more stoic, serious, kind of by the books character.
But then they kind of
Not as
forgot.
by the books as Mordo, of course, because he was okay with Wong saving the fucking universe.
Strange.
At the expense of, you know, tampering with time and natural law, something which Birdman thinks is a mistake or a questionable decision, as we all know him for.
Yes.
But now Wong is more, he just kind of doesn't give a shit. And No Way Home, we find out that apparently Strange continued to fight him on whether he should use the memory erasing spell, and he just says, "Just leave me out of
Just
it."
leave me out of it.
And he just fucking leaves. The trailer made him look more competent in that he just said, "Don't fucking do it," and then he
Yeah, and
leaves.
then Strange
Not
does
he's
it
stuck
behind his
around.
back, yeah.
Yeah.
But do you know that that memory erasing spell is going to be brought up again in this episode? I know that because I've seen the scene and yeah.
I do not know that, but
Yeah. Yeah, we'll see why it's brought up. We'll see what Wong says about it. I'm sure it's going to be fine.
The parole board will not release him after seeing this video.
Oh, I know what you're thinking, Miss Walters. And I'm not erasing everyone's memories, not again.
Should I give context for what's happened in these two episodes?
No.
No. No.
I really don't care, Jeb. Yeah. This is very specifically about Wong, and the rest of the episode is just because I couldn't be fucked to edit down the episode to just the
They
Wong
have
scenes.
I saw the first like 2 seconds. They have a recap of episode 1 and 2.
Ah, see, that's than enough.
Yeah, the cliff notes.
Mm-hmm. Also, this is the episode with that ant tag that we've seen all around Twitter. So we're going to have to experience that. So I'm sorry if you're watching this for the first time.
The ant tag?
Yeah.
The antagonist?
No, the ant tag.
Oh, ant tag.
Yeah. Not end tag. Zod, you haven't been watching She-Hulk, right? Because sometimes you watch shit and don't tell us.
No, I haven't touched it.
Oh, good. For you. I'm proud of you.
Good job. Thank you.
Yeah. Play.
Are we playing She-Hulk?
We are, unfortunately.
Let's fucking go.
My favorite show.
Can't wait for Wong to definitely not be ruined any further.
Wong is the best. He's going to be fine. Do you know about the Wong pit? Madvika, the lore of the Wong.
Yeah, you told
pit.
Me about it.
Yeah.
From Multiverse of Madness.
Indeed.
Yeah, then she throws Wong down the Wong pit, and then Wong is dead. Rip Wong.
By the way, is the Wong pit something you guys discovered when I went to go make a sandwich?
I think he was. I think it was when you spilled a drink on your laptop, on your keyboard.
Yeah. Because I have no recollection.
Dude,
of
the Wong pit was the funniest shit last night. Because we're just like thinking of all the things, like, oh, you could just come up with a new Wong by throwing things down there. You throw a pebble, there's a new Wong. Oh, they threw the three guards down there. All the three Wongs are going to come out. Because, yeah, there's no reason for him to have survived that fall except for the Wong pit. So the Wong pit is canon.
So we can all justify him being out of character because it's not the original Wong.
It's not the first Wong. It's a new, brand new Wong.
Brand new out of character Wong. Yeah.
First case is the parole of Emil Blonsky, also known as Abomination.
Wait, so she's representing Abomination?
Yes.
Yes. And Hulk is okay with this because Abomination sent a haiku.
Haikus that I've written.
Oh boy.
To each of my victims expressing the sorrow.
Off screen. And it was all resolved. I'm not kidding.
So the legal case is about what happened in Shang-Chi. Does it have anything to do with what happened in The Incredible Hulk in Harlem?
So it's originally, the parole thing is about the events of Incredible Hulk, but this is from the spanner in the work.
So I guess he was about to go out on parole, but because he was being taken out to fight in the underground fighting ring in Macao,
he was about to face the parole board with her to represent, and then the news broke out of this.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like a fucking idiot, he accepted to fight Wong.
You not only escaped from prison, but you were also recorded doing so.
I was forced to leave my cell, but I returned of my own free will.
So Wong opened a portal under him, is what he's saying.
Sorcerer supreme of the mystic arts, and his name is
Wong. Just Wong.
Damn it. I was hoping we'd find out his last name in the show.
And Wong just tells him everything.
Which, to be fair, they are being consistent with the joke in Doctor Strange, which I like.
Just Wong? Like Adele?
He's just Wong.
Yeah.
Like Beyonce.
Adele.
I just like how Wong gave away his identity and everything to Abomination, who probably never knew.
I know, you can't wait to see Wong. I get it. I just want to make sure that you don't think this is one of those cameo every week type of shows.
Yeah, we don't really care about you, She-Hulk. Oh, did you not know that she breaks the fourth wall? Yeah, she breaks the fourth wall all the time. Yeah.
Just remember whose show this actually is.
That's fine, but can you have your
Is this an automatic driving car?
Yeah.
No, not on the wheel.
To be fair, she's breaking the fourth wall, so you're not supposed to think like she's actually doing it.
Cartoon physics.
Yeah, I want to just break it forth more. The pacing is really bad in this already, but whatever. That's a terrible photo. She's like mid moving her mouth.
She's mid.
That's just the end of the sentence.
Sorry, that was pretty misogynistic of me.
They took the Hulk's manhood away, but then they gave it to a woman?
Oh, hey, Nerdrotic cameo, nice.
Oh, yeah. I saw a screenshot of that part, of those, like, fake tweets.
It's super weird to have this in universe, though. Like, I get it from, like, a meta sense, but in universe, it doesn't really make sense, but who cares? Oh my god, that's CGI! Oh no! Oh no! Shit, that looks so bad!
It looks like
leave
a GTA
scene.
It's a career mode football.
Exactly.
This is a TV budget.
It looks like the FIFA career mode transfer negotiations. Exactly, Jeb.
Jennifer Walter speaking.
Is her password already entered on Windows and she just hasn't hit enter?
She always leaves her password there in case she forgets.
Oh, that's fair enough.
Yeah.
I'm sure nothing bad will happen because of that.
To be fair, most people keep their password, like, on a note right next to their
sticky note on the monitor.
Yeah, that's not even a joke. People IRL do that because people are stupid.
I don't want to hear anyone complaining about that being like a plot hole or a stupid character decision when someone leaves a sticky note.
Well, it depends on who's doing it. When it's like Tony Stark, you think maybe not you, but
no, you would totally do that.
Also, Adrian Chase from Arrow. Cameo. Also not cameo, he's just in the show, but anyway.
He is also in the superhuman lot of
it. Yeah. No, I can't talk to a 10 about embarrassing man stuff.
Embarrassing man stuff?
That's...
Is this guy like a toxic man?
Well, yeah, he called her a 10, so I guess, so that's...
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It wasn't just me interpreting it like that.
No, it's just weird dialogue because they don't know how to write sexist men.
Why is a 40-year-old doing like the she's a 10 thing?
I don't know.
Thought that was like a Zoomer thing.
Not inherently. In How Much Your Mother, Barney does that all the time, and he isn't a Zoomer.
The girlfriend in question is a shape-shifting light elf from New Asgard.
Well, to be fair, I thought I was dating Megan Thee Stallion.
You thought you were dating Megan Thee Stallion?
Oh, here we go. Yes. This is what I've been hearing about.
I love this. This subplot is going to be amazing. Megan Thee Stallion is my favorite artist. I probably have heard one of her songs at one point. Dude, her suit does not fit her properly. It really annoys me. Like, it's texturing. Ah, fuck you. It's show. CGI artists deserve better than working under this bullshit.
Pug, good luck. Dennis?
Look the way she moves. It's like, here we are.
I extracted him from the prison against his own wishes because I required a worthy opponent as part of my training to become Sorcerer Supreme.
Oh, shut the fuck up.
Yep, he required a worthy opponent.
You can conjure up like beasts. Strange did that in Multiverse of Madness.
Indeed.
How is Abomination the worthy opponent?
They can literally travel anywhere in the multiverse to fight beings from other dimensions, and he fucking needs Abomination.
Go to the fucking forest. Go to the forest and fight him. Why do you have to do it in front of a crowd of innocent people?
I don't
What the
know.
Fuck did he do during the 5-year span?
Oh yeah, that's true, because he did that right at the end, right? Because that was after the blip. Why didn't he fucking do that in the beginning? Why did you wait so long to become the Sorcerer Supreme, Wong? I guess he was just waiting for Strange to come back and be like, oh shit, now I gotta actually become the Sorcerer Supreme, shit. He's just fucking scratching his balls, just waiting around.
Why didn't he just fight Bruce?
Yeah, I don't know.
Why does he need to fight a fucking Hulk?
Why does he need to fight anyone?
Because it's a worthy opponent, apparently.
Yeah.
So that battle can be legendary.
Yeah.
He literally went against a brute in Infinity War.
Yeah, he doesn't have to fight another experienced sorcerer. He has to fight a giant strong man. Because he totally won't overpower them.
Yeah, because it's not like he's
good, guys.
He-Hulk
is good.
But anyway, Magic, are you happy with the answer?
I will be in touch, Mr. Bukowski.
Are these guys gay? Why is like the tension so awkward? He was like afraid to give him a handshake.
It's because
is he afraid to touch another man?
It's a comedy, you know. But yeah, Magica, that was the answer for the long-awaited question. I'm sure that commenter is now proven right, and you're just nitpicker.
Yeah, I was a fool for being so impatient.
Yeah, we got an answer, and it was amazing.
Yeah, an answer that doesn't raise more questions.
No, none whatsoever.
No, not at all.
Are they going to put the light elf to call? Because I'm going to say good luck with that.
Wait, what'd you say?
It seems like they want to try and put the light elf to call, and I'm like, how the fuck are you going to do that?
Light elf? What?
Light elf? What is that?
Oh,
well, that's what. That's the shapeshifting.
It's an Asgardian. Yeah, they want to sue her for pretending to be Megan Thee Stallion. Court advocate. You know, the thing that your favorite character, Matt Murdock, goes through sometimes.
I thought Jeb was saying they had, like, decorations that were light elf themed.
What the fuck is happening?
Jeb,
to make her more
I am
welcome
not...
or something.
All right, you're the one paying attention to the dialogue. I'm just the Wong stuff is what matters to me. So good at you for trying to figure it out, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm here for.
When Wong testifies in court, that's what matters. But
I just want to work out this Asgardian shit.
No, it's Megan Thee Stallion, Joe White.
Can we get a word? Is it true you were rejected by the Avengers? Jennifer Walters, also known as She-Hulk, rumored to have been rejected by the Avengers.
What?
The Avengers aren't, like, even a thing anymore.
Yeah, they're not a thing anymore.
We don't even know, like, what's going on with the Avengers. Yeah. How do they know who they fucking reject?
Nobody fucking talks to each other.
If they're still a thing, then No Way Home and Falcon and Winter Soldier, and, well, basically everything since then is just broken, I guess.
Oh, there's some women for the haikus. He sent loving haikus to a bunch of pen pals.
We do have a witness who is able to clear Mr. Blonsky of any wrongdoing on his part. Then we'll start with that then.
Is it Wong?
Yeah, it is.
Yes.
He's going to testify and take blame.
The guy who fucking broke him out in the first place.
Yeah.
Do you feel you have been rehabilitated?
My God, Tim Roth is such an amazing actor. How is he so shit here?
Did his brain rot while he was... Well, I guess he's literally rotting in a cell, so... Yeah. Probably got some brain damage.
Tim Roth.
Tim Roth.
Tim Roth.
I have changed emotionally, physically, metaphysically, spiritually, karmically, cosmically, interdimensionally,
etc.
I love
this is a comedy. That's why this dialogue is the way it is.
She-Hulk is good.
Yeah, Madvicky, you can't wait for Matt Murdock, Daredevil himself, to show up in this comedy. It's gonna be great.
Well,
this is the only part of the show that I'm watching, so I don't have to worry about that.
I forgot for a period of time, and now I remembered.
He plans to open a meditation retreat.
How does Mr. Blonsky intend to fund this?
Oh my Christ.
Mr. Blonsky is currently in a long-term committed relationship with several pen pals, all of whom have pledged to financially support him.
What?
I know.
Huh?
What's in the seven hells?
So, what?
Are these his wives?
They're his pen pals.
Why are they horny for him?
Because it's Tim Roth and he can become big. So his penis probably can become big. Yeah.
He leads daily guided meditation and yoga for the prisoners.
Where's Wong? Why is he late?
He's fighting some other giant beast. Apparently there was a part two to the becoming a Sorcerer Supreme that he forgot about.
He wants to become the Sorcerer Supreme.
Yeah.
Just to get the extra Supreme rank.
Yeah. He wants to get the little trademark logo next to the Sorcerer Supreme name. He should fight another monster.
He saved you from a bad marriage. I release you, Linda.
Proud of you, Carl.
I love you so much.
What is happening with Carl?
Who knows?
There's still the matter of Mr. Blonsky's escape.
Wait, have they never prosecuted Wong on that matter? They're just going after Abomination.
They're having them witness, man, despite the witness commit the crime.
Yeah, this is fucking wild. Oh, hey, there he is.
Not bad at all. Took long enough.
My apologies, Miss Walters. Emil.
Finally!
I lost track of time.
Oh, fuck you, Wong.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
He doesn't have a fucking cell phone to set an alarm.
He doesn't have a watch. Even Strange has a fucking watch.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'd like to move for dismissal of all charges against my client. Runa is the daughter of an elfin diplomat on Asgard and now in New Asgard. As such, she has diplomatic immunity.
So she's actually...
Diplomatic
immunity? Fuck me.
We are not in New Asgard.
Excuse me, Your Honor, but Asgard is not a place. It is a people.
Whoa, she said the thing!
Oh, wait. Are they really? Oh, fuck you. Undermining that fucking line. It's such a good line from Thor. Fuck off.
Yeah.
We're in a consensual relationship and engaged in roleplay.
Oh, gross.
No rational adult would have believed my client's texts were from the real Megan Thee Stallion.
This scene is not realistic at all, and how a court has handled it or whatever.
Why?
Yeah, and everyone still has hope for Daredevil.
Why are we having this retarded subplot? Like, Jen isn't here, so why would I care?
Yeah, wait, who am I supposed to care about in this scene?
I guess...
Is the guy, like, the secondary
Yeah, he's
actor?
Probably a supporting character, Adrian Chase. Right, Jeb?
Sorry, I'm kind of losing my mind. What's that?
Adrian Chase, the lawyer. Is he the one we're supposed to care about in this scene?
I don't...
I'm changing my ruling. Oh, come on, Runa. This is getting a little broad.
Impersonating a judge is illegal. Get down from there.
We shouldn't
care about
any of
them. Then where's the fucking judge?
Yeah, she's impersonating a judge. Her impersonating a judge would get her arrested. Anyway, because my point is, yeah, I don't understand why we had that scene.
Because She-Hulk is good, apparently, and we get shit like this. Accept it. It's good.
absolutely his choice to return. I offered him asylum at Kamataj, but he was quite adamant he'd be returned to serve out his sentence and repay his debt to society.
Trust me, I've seen.
Wait, he sent him to an asylum in Kamataj?
No, he wanted to.
He wanted to
house him at Kamataj, but Blonsky was like, no, I want to finish my sentence because I'm a good person, I guess.
So Wong freely breaks the rules.
Why did he want to do that? Wong?
I don't know.
Because he needed a worthy opponent, Madvocate. It makes sense.
So this is even worse. He didn't just want to continuously break him out of prison. He wanted him to live at Kamataj so he could fight him until he was done with him. That's so fucking stupid.
I think it wasn't until he was done with him. I think after he was done with Abomination, he's like, I can offer you a place to stay if you want.
Once he's out of prison.
Yeah, after they fought, he was like, oh, you can stay at Kamataj instead of staying in prison because it's obviously nicer because he wouldn't be...
That's what I'm saying. That's fucking stupid.
Yeah. Well, you were saying, like, using him until he was done with him. It's just, like, housing him even after he was done with him is, like, I think, what Wong was thinking.
As you can see, I'm in full control.
Fine. Totally fine.
Emil!
Calm down.
Oh, my God. There was the way his voice sounds. Oh, yeah. All right, calm down.
Yeah, I don't understand why he sounds like Tim Roth, unless it fits for the funny, like, fucking Hulk.
In Incredible Hulk, Hulk fucking sounds like how they usually do as a human, because they're all growly and shit. Like, honestly, it'd be funnier if it was his Hulk voice.
Yeah, and just talking very calmly and growling.
just like, all right, calm down.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, Professor Hulk makes sense, because he's both Bruce and Hulk.
Yeah,
but they apply that to every Hulk for some reason now. So.
But Abomination is still Abomination.
This show is good.
It's great. Yeah.
It's good because funny.
I haven't laughed once during this entire
show. Why? I get why General Ross isn't here because the actor is dead. Why isn't he here in universe?
For Mr. Wong, just Wong. The Sorcerer Supreme, Master of the Mystic Arts, leader and former librarian of Kamataj.
Yeah.
This is not funny.
Just admitted to facilitating a prisoner escape, which is a crime.
I must depart.
But his heart was in the right place, Your Honor.
What? You're just gonna let him? Okay. He's just gonna fuck off.
What?
That's actually hilarious.
Well, they know where he is. Yeah. He said Kamataj a million times.
It's also out of character for him. He's always been the one to follow rules. You remember fucking Doctor Strange about the Strange stealing books? And he was like, fuck off.
Well, this is this is another Wong that came out of the Wong.
Oh, yeah, that's true. It's not the original
that's
Wong.
That's hilarious. He just goes, yeah, I'm fucking off now. See ya.
Yeah. He's like, oh, you committed a crime. I gotta go.
But you see him leaving and nobody doing anything about it is funny, and this is a comedy.
Oh, yeah, it's true. It is a comedy.
Yeah, he's just actually added to his crimes.
Yeah.
Is that it? Or are we... How?
I'm pretty sure that's
we have like
all
a fourth
the
of the episode.
Well, it's like 5 minutes left only, or like four, because the credits in these Disney Plus shows take like 300 years to finish.
That's
true. Have a post-credits.
Oh, yeah, that's the... Oh, yeah.
No.
We're gonna have to wait until the end to watch the post-credits scene, yeah. We have to watch it, okay?
I don't want to.
You're gonna need that. Connecting the A and B story? Nice.
Oh, fucking up. Her commenting on
Wait,
the writing,
what?
Connecting on the A and B story.
No.
Like, Christ.
What? Wait, so it's not just breaking the fourth wall, like, telling the audience, like, what's happening or how she's feeling? It's, she's literally aware that she's in a TV show.
And she's making jokes, yeah. This is doing the Deadpool, because, obviously, wait, she's like this in the comic, she also breaks the fourth wall, but there's a way to break the fourth wall that is like Fleabag, and there's a way to break the fourth wall that is like Deadpool. If you do it like Fleabag, it's fine, but if it's like Deadpool, you're like, dude, you know you're in a story. Like, he breaks the suspension of disbelief.
I thought it was like simple fourth wall breaking.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
I don't care about the fourth wall break.
I do, Jeff.
We got more pressing. We got a more pressing issue right now. We're doing this trial despite this woman being provably impersonating people for fun.
Oh, yeah.
Impersonating a fucking judge.
Yeah, she impersonated a judge in front of everyone. So why are we still doing this?
And she would have had to, like, restrain him to prevent him from actually showing up and being like, wait, I'm the real judge.
Dennis Bukowski is an almost pathologically entitled man. He would absolutely believe that he's dating the real Megan Thee Stallion because he is truly that delusional.
This is fucking weird.
This is fucking stupid. The
base for their argument is, oh, he really thought he was good enough to pull a woman like that.
Yeah.
It's like, but she looks exactly and sounds exactly like her.
And has acted like her while they were dating. It. Yeah.
Yeah, how would he not believe that?
In addition, we also sentenced the defendant to 60 days for impersonating a judge.
Oh, yay, impersonating a judge.
Oh, they actually got around to that. What the fuck?
If you think the show is good, you got beat as a child. I don't care. fucking hell.
Is the show, I think the show's already going to be done when this is released, because it's going to be released during the 2-year anniversary. So, hey, Jeb, maybe this you're just going to be proven wrong.
This is just fucking nothing salad, a waste of shit.
No, Jeb. It's going to become great. You just wait until Daredevil shows up.
I'd rather watch Loki, because this is just fucking annoying. Loki, I can like go, oh, nice visuals or nice music. No, this is just cringe, fucking annoying shite.
Yeah, I mean, episode 5 of Loki had the Richard E. Grant, and he was fun. The music is
yeah.
good.
We hereby grant Mr. Blonsky's release on parole, effective immediately.
Okay, what are you going to do about Wong?
All right.
Wong is... he's off somewhere.
Mr. Blonsky is prohibited from turning into Abomination indefinitely. And is ordered to wear an inhibitor in perpetuity.
I mean, that's fine.
I'm guessing he was able to control his transformation over the fucking 15 years he's been here, I guess.
I imagine that was explained when he turned there in the earlier scene, but we were talking over it, but I think so.
It wasn't explained. He just did it over the 15 years.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, right then.
Everything about Abomination and Bruce is just off-screen.
Amazing, I love it.
Wonderful.
The CGI.
She-Hulk.
Yeah, my name's Jennifer Walters, not She-Hulk.
As I appear as She-Hulk, which defeats my...
Isn't the point that she's doing that because of, publicity for her lawyer company or whatever?
When we come back, She-Hulk shares her diet and exercise secrets.
I'm sorry, what?
They would have asked you before, you moron.
I do believe that would be occurring.
Yeah, there's right. When they interview people, they ask whether the questions are okay to be answered. Whatever.
It's a comedy.
Oh fuck! I'm sorry. Stop. I didn't realize that.
She-Hulk is good. I haven't heard a compelling argument against it.
The fuck? Flaming helmet?
Oh, this is the Wrecking Crew. Wrecking Crew.
I've heard about this.
Yeah, people were really mad at it.
The fuck is the Wrecking Crew?
It's something from the comics that people were mad at because it was shit in this show.
Did you guys rob an Asgardian construction worker?
Yeah.
Why did they think they had any chance to begin with?
Whoa, it's Asgardian magic. They should have a chance against her. I don't understand
exactly.
What they don't. I miss Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
So that person's dead.
Oh my god.
Dead.
Holy shit. Holy. No, he's not alive, show. I'm sorry. Dead.
Did all of them get in the car?
Yes.
They just
ran
away.
They're trying to get her blood to make Hulk.
I need a second take because...
Wait. If they wanted the blood, why didn't the guy...
Didn't she just throw some guy in the air?
Yes, but that's what we're talking about. They should have died. But if the point was to get her blood, why did they wait until she turned into She-Hulk? When there was literally a guy who got the jump on her, grabbed her by the neck, could have just got her blood from her before she became the She-Hulk.
I guess the boss is the boss Kingpin? I don't know. They mentioned the boss. I don't know who that is.
I guess it could be because they're gonna have Daredevil soon, maybe. So anyway,
what the fuck was that?
Is this a Mega T Stallion song? My ears are being raped.
Yeah, let's talk over it. I don't want to listen to it. That was great.
That just breezed right out. That just blew past really quick, and it was fucking nothing.
Yeah, there was nothing of value in that. Yeah, I don't. Sure.
Oh my god.
I'm very glad I'm not watching this show.
Should we wait for the next episode? Is that really everything they explored regarding Abomination and Wong?
Seems like it.
Well, this is the thing. It's going
to
be in the next episode, but I think that's all of there is of Wong stuff in it. I don't think there's anything more. I can check when we watch when the next episode comes out.
Apparently.
When the next episode comes out, I'm gonna watch the Wong scenes just to check if we do need to watch it. But
those poor VFX artists, those poor bastards.
Oh Jesus Christ!
That was TV.
People
right
said
there.
The show is doing good. These people just don't pay attention at this point. I don't know where you generate that conclusion from.
No, this episode's great. I laughed so much because I love Megan Thee Stallion and Jennifer Walters, I think is her name. Emil Blonsky as well is also one of my favorite characters. Wong. I just love seeing the characters that I like in TV. So it was fun. 10 out of 10.
Yay. What I was saying earlier is that I don't know why the fucking Wrecking Crew thought they had a chance is because their weapons were basically standard weapons or gauntlets or whatever, and they were glowing. And it's like, okay, I guess they just hit like a little bit harder.
Well, they said they
but it's like it's She-Hulk, and they're not even like actual Asgardians. They said they stole it.
But that's the thing. If it is Asgardian weapons, then it should do better than it is. But then the show is just like, no, actually, whatever.
Right. Not against the Hulk, though.
Oh, I guess it should be this right. Well, yeah. Well, fucking Hulk could never lift the Thor's hammer, for example. Which, to be fair, he is. It is.
But it had a spell on it.
Well, yeah, but that's the point. Every Asgardian weapon has some kind of magic surrounding it. Like the Berserker Staff.
Citation?
You remember that in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.?
Citation?
Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. has the Berserker Staff.
That's not canon, though.
Oh, yeah, all my citations would be from Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., so yeah, whatever.
Damn it, Sky. You have me defending She-Hulk of all things now.
Yeah. Well, then it's just kind of like pointless, right? Because then the point is that the weapons are useless unless you're... You are an Asgardian.
So what hero is the Wrecking Crew's main protagonist? Because I don't for one second believe like they're gonna be a main conflict in this show. They're just a bunch of fucking punks
that didn't do anything. The Wrecker, Bulldozer, Pile Driver, and Thunderbolt.
These are their names.
Yeah.
and apparently they were in a Thor comic. And they fought the Defenders, so...
Oh, okay, well, that makes more sense. Not She-Hulk, but...
Yeah, and they...
I guess they're just saying...
They're more like sort of street-level sort stuff.
Yeah, it seems like their villains are Punisher and the Defenders, yeah.
So they're just setting up the Daredevil show.
Probably. Echo and then Daredevil.
Just gonna see what they're theorizing and slip off. I don't think of Fisk. Titania...
Man, it's gonna be...
Well, it'd be weird if we did Fisk again, because he was the big bad in Hawkeye.
Yeah, but we have to build him up because of Daredevil. Wait, Vulture? Vulture's in another universe, what?
Yeah, I know.
Vulture's literally in the Sony-verse.
One person thinks the leader.
I guess it makes sense.
Like a few leaks, so maybe, plus this is all Hulk-related, so yeah, maybe that say... one's... Plus, like, they bring back Abomination, so bringing back the leader from the... Incredible Hulk would also not be too out of left field.
Oh yeah, because they did set that up. It just never.
Yeah, they set him up in like one thing, and like he was resolved in like a tie-in comic like 10 years ago.
Oh, that's great! I love how Marvel does that. Wow, that was amazing. Man. I'm so glad we did this.
Daredevil's gonna be so good. I can't wait to not watch it.
I'm scared.
Don't watch it, Jeb. Nobody should be watching it. I don't get it. None of us, at least.
I'm not gonna watch. War. Yeah, Jeb is the only one who's been watching like every single Marvel thing. It's kind of impressive.
Whoa, chill.
Chill.
Consumer.
Chill.
MCU chill.
I still haven't finished Ms. Marvel, and I like that show.
I haven't even gone past like episode 2 of or 3 of Moon Knight. I haven't done anything else after.
Yeah, I only saw episode 1 of Ms. Marvel, and then gave up on Moon Knight after like 3 or 4. I don't even remember what happened in that show.
It all kind of goes to shit, so don't worry.
Yeah, the finale is quite cringe. Yeah, thanks everyone for watching. Now you can get back to the rest of the ECUM anniversary, where we aren't talking about She-Hulk, hopefully, because Jesus Christ, I don't want to talk about the show again. Yeah, we'll catch you all later. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Happy anniversary.
Jeb ate his microphone.
Jeb did his microphone. And yes, happy 2-year anniversary for ECUM.
Fuck ECUM.
Oh my god.
ECUM.
And as Sorcerer Supreme, I insist that he not be punished for my actions.
2 seconds later.
We'll send him to the mirror dimension.
I don't know what that is, but no.
Shadow dimension?